Hello everyone, it's Patty. Welcome back to my channel. And today I'm finally back with a flip through. And this is for the setup that I actually just finished using the November kit from the Planner Society. Now, it has taken me a minute. I was looking for the perfect planner to use with this kit because I totally adore the kit. The kit is kind of like, as this constellation, moon kind of theme. And I really wanted to find the perfect planner to use it with. So I came across this Discagenda that I actually had in my stash for the longest time, and I completely forgot all about it because I don't use a Discagenda, and I think it was gifted to me at an event or I won it. So what I did is I transformed the Discagenda into a traveler notebook, and because I saw that the inserts would B6 inserts would fit inside it. So as you can tell, the agenda is black. It actually has gold hardware because it has these cute little stars everywhere. And I cover here the button using one of these kind of Swarovski crystals from Michaels. Now on the side, you'll see the elastics here. I basically just punched holes here on the spine using a hole puncher, so you can easily do that. And then I just threaded some elastic through it, and then I just basically transformed it into a traveler notebook, which is what I prefer to use. So here is a look at the inside, and as you can tell, there's gold here in the background, which kind of bothers me just a tad because the metal, there's more silver kind of like, kind of colors throughout the kit, but I mean, it doesn't bother me that much. Now, on this side, there's some pockets, and you can tell it says Discagenda Constellations. And again, I have no idea how I got this, but I've included here the sticky notes that came with the kit. Then I have a few stickers from Purpose Paperies, and she has all these cute little kind of moon phases stickers, and these are the little ones, so I just stuck them in there. Then I have this washi card from Simply Gilded with crystals on it, and it's got this prismatic effect. And then I have a little paper clip here from Peonies Papery, and from Lamb. I love her little paper clip. This is my favorite one. And then I have the inserts. So I have, as always, three sections because that's kind of how I like to keep my planners, which is, I think, is the perfect size for me. It's enough but not too much. And I also was kind of, I had to kind of pay attention to the volume because, as you can tell, this is meant for a Discagenda. So although I have room, because I usually like to use a lot of 3D embellishments, I just didn't want to, go overboard because this does not really stretch. You know, this is kind of probably it's full capacity, so I cannot really add that much. Now, the first inserts, I have a cover here using some vellum, and the vellum is from Happy Scrappy, from one of the older kits. And here in the front, I have used this initial that I got from Michaels. I found them when they were like 25 cents each, I think, on the website. These are my favorite initials, and I stocked up. I think I bought 40 of them, but I always use them. And then here's my first dashboard, which is for this is actually a Michaels insert that I received, I think, from Go Wild. And I just covered basically the insert with the paper from the Planner Society. And this is my favorite paper. It is black background. It has constellation. It has some stars in silver foiling. And on the corners here, I've added the edge corner, the scalloped edges here that are just, I just love these. They add so much, it's just, they're flat, they don't have much volume, but they had a lot of punch. And so as you can tell, I like the way that, they kind of line them up. I usually try to alternate them. So you'll see a silver, then a gold, and a silver again. And then this is one of the cards, the journaling cards that came in the kit. It says Find Your Voice. And I have backed it with paper from, Hobby Lobby. It's from Hobby Lobby, and it's kind of thick, and it's a pain to cut, honestly. And it has little, not glitter, but I can't think of the word now, sequins. It has little sequins on it. And and then I attached the card to the basically paper with the sequins using some brads, and then I backed it with some white kind of cardstock that is glittery, just because I wanted to lighten it up, because there's so much black in this that I didn't want it to be gloomy. And then here in the bottom I have used ribbon that I got from Target a long time ago, and then a little glitter little bow on the top. So that's insert number one. And in the back I just have another this is one of the pockets that came with the kit, and I used the stickers that came with the kit to add shine bright now a little star. And then I have two washi cards from Simply Gilded that I filled out with washi tape from the Planner Society and Simply Gilded. I love how they match. And then here's the back of the vellum from Epi Scrappy, and there's another sticker from the kit. I really love these stickers, they're so pretty. And then to transition from one to the other dashboards, I have used these doilies that you can get at Michael's. They were on clearance last time I checked. And then here is the acetate from the kit, which is beautiful. It has this silver, you know, design on one side, and it's black on the other. And I decided to go with the black just because you can see so much darkness on this side, and I just felt like it was too much of a jump just to go into this, you know, silver on this side too. And then here I have added the Planner Girl, like little 3D sticker words that came in the, I think this is from actually the Halloween kit from the Planner Society. And then another vellum, always from Happy Scrappy. It's got cute little bows. I can recognize the bows from Once More We Love. And from, I think this one is from Scribble Prints Co. And that one is from Amanda. Now the name of the store escapes me, but it'll come back to me. And Fox and Pip, that's the word. And here is the sticker, Seeking the Stars. And then here is insert number two, which is also the insert for my Annieplansprintables inserts. And actually Annie has a matching you know, set of insert that you can purchase that match this set, which I used in my third insert. But for the monthly, I always use this style, which is dedated and timed, and it's three columns, so you can use all your stickers. And I just love this layout, it's my favorite one. So and Annie's are my favorite inserts. And for the cover, I used the black and white cover, which is the black edges here. And then I really did a triple basically layering here, because I don't know, I wanted to use this to pop out, but at the same time this was so dark and this is so bright that I needed some distance between the two. So it's another one of the little journaling cards. It says Moon Phases, and I have a little bow here, and then I have the little sequin paper, and then again the white glitter, and then I put a little, just a little smidge of black glitter just to transition better from the front to the back. And as usual, the little eyelets here or reds. And here's the insert. And I left it here as is just because I love this paper. It doesn't really go with the, you know, the color scheme, but I wanted to show you how it is the back. And then here is the back of the insert. It is not a pocket from the Planner Society, which actually now that I think, this is the one that came with this kit. But this one that I showed you earlier, and I just remembered, this one came with a different kit. So I don't remember, I know you guys will know it, but this one is the one that came with this, the November kit. Then here I put the one of the stickers from the kit, and then You Are the Universe, and then stickers from the kit. Back of the vellum, Explore the Unseen, back of the acetate, just the word happy from the same Halloween kit. Then we have the doily, and then I have the jelly paper cover that I move basically from planner to planner because I am too lazy to buy another sheet of jelly paper. And it's actually a little, it's not short, it just keeps on bending. And I have the word love, which I do think was from Michael's. I got it a long time ago. And then the last insert, I went back to the black paper. So when I do not have like a perfect match, like when I want to keep to the same color scheme, like I didn't want to bring in a new pattern just because I wanted to leave it as monochromatic and simple, but at the same time, I don't know, I just felt like adding a different design was just going to distract. And so I used the same paper that I used for the same insert. And again, the same glitter edgers and the little card says make your own magic with the same sequin background and then the glitter paper and then the target little ribbon here and another ribbon. And this is the answer that I was telling you about. So these are the ones that you can get on Annie Plans. So this is actually for your expenses. So, you know, it's the beginning of the year. It's always good to start tracking your expenses. And in the back here, I have this little pocket, which I think was from, I got it a long time ago. I think it's made of like jelly paper, but it's kind of hard. I think it's from Happy Scrappy. And then I have some stickers from the Planner Society. And then I put the sticker that says she was the type of girl the moon chased and the stars wished for. I love the saying and little the sentiments and all these little stickers. Then here's the back of the jelly paper. And here there's another pocket in this Discagenda. So I have used the second little sticky notepad that you get in this month's kit. Popped one of the little paper clips from Peony's Papery. And then here's the pen that comes with the kit. And this is it, guys. I was planning to do a washi dashboard for it. But then when I tried to push it in there, it wasn't really, it was gonna add a little too much, and this is already at full capacity. So I hope you liked it, but if you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to me on Instagram. I always answer every DM, and I hope you have a wonderful rest of your week. Bye-bye.